Hello and welcome back to Cautionary Global Financial Analysis. This is a comparison between the what's called gold miners here. This is SIC 1040 gold and silver ores. These are six mining companies focused on gold and some silver and possibly other precious metals. So we're going to begin with first their names, symbols, Newmont Mining, symbol NEW. Gold, that's Barrick Gold. AU is Anglo Ashanti Gold. AEM is Agnico Eagle Mines. WPM is Wheaton Precious Metals. And FNV is Franco Nevada. So we begin by introducing the five metrics here. The first two here are in a range of 0 to 1. Or alternatively 0 to 100%. And the last three are as cash flow to revenues as a percentage. So beginning with the coverage metric, we see here that the best coverage based on existing financing obligations, which is debt service and dividends, is Barrick Gold, which is just about 47%. The next is Wheaton Precious Metals, and the others have very low coverage based on the existing financing obligations. Moving on to the negative cash flow scenario, this is the possible outcomes where the cash flows would fall into negative cash flow territory. And we see here that in the case of Agnico, Eagle, we're at about 50%, as well as for Franco Nevada. So over 50% of the possible outcomes would fall into negative cash flow territory. This is followed by Wheaton Precious Metals at 22% rounded, and the others in the 10% range. The best performer is Newmont Mining at just under 5%. Moving on to centrality, again, this is in terms of cash flow to revenues. We see that WPM performs far above the others, and it's not exactly clear how this is possible, so that would warrant further research. But most of them tend to be 20% and below. Now, moving on to the maximum acceptable exposure level, there's a 5% scenario, a little hard to see here, and a 10% scenario. This is based on potential for a financing obligations capacity coverage. This is potential. It's not based on existing figures and how much they can actually cover in terms of finance obligations. As you'll see here, with the exception of Newmont Mining, with a slight positive at 2% of revenues, all of the other firms actually are at a 5% level of acceptable exposure. None of the others are able to cover any amount of financing obligations, potentially. Then moving up to 10%, again, Newmont Mining is the top performer here at almost 10% of revenues at this exposure level. Now, of note here is these incredibly high figures here. I should say, in this case, actually, it's incredibly low figures for the this financing obligations coverage. This suggests that the companies are relying upon external financing sources to continue in operation, even if they're producing heavily negative cash flows. Conclusion, of course, the final point might be that Newmont Mining here, Barrick, has a fair amount of coverage capacity here, as we've already seen, but in the 5% scenario and even the 10% scenario, it really is not capable of covering a lot of its financing, or any really level of financing obligations. So why is that the case? The main reason is in the distribution of the cash flows. The coverage is looking at the entire distribution. So this 47% is in relationship to entire distribution, whereas these are looking at the tail of the distribution, and that's where you see really these huge divergences. That it's a lot of the activity for these companies is in the tails. And also just a reminder that the figures are preliminary, they are estimates. And thank you very much for listening.